The idea leading to the formation of Deutsche Bank in 1870 took shape in times of upheaval in the banking sector. Industry's financial needs were growing in the wake of industrialization and called for new developments in traditional banking business. In Berlin, a number of private bankers were open to new ideas, and the driving force behind them was Adalbert Delbrück, head of the banking house Delbrück, Leo & Company. Together with Ludwig Bamberger, politician, banker, and expert in monetary theory, Delbrück is regarded as the true founder of Deutsche Bank. The name, Deutsche Bank, was soon chosen and was programmatic for the bank itself. On the eve of the foundation of the first national German state, it was the initiator's declared intention to create a German bank, which had its headquarters in the capital of the politically and economically predominant Prussia and would release Germany's foreign trade from its dependence on English and French banks. The new bank was to specialize in foreign trade, as underlined in the Articles of Association approved by the Constitutive Assembly on January 22, 1870. The purpose of the company is the transaction of banking business of all kinds, in particular, the promotion and easing of trade relations between Germany, the other European countries, and overseas markets. But there were still political obstacles to be surmounted. In Prussia, namely, all previous applications to set up joint stock banks had been turned down by the government. This time, however, the decision was different, thanks to the founders' reputations and the importance attributed to the bank project for Berlin as a major financial center. On March 10, 1870, King Wilhelm I signed the concession to set up the company Deutsche Bank Aktiengesellschaft. This document is considered to be the actual birth certificate of Deutsche Bank. The door was now open for the first general meeting of shareholders, at which 76 shareholders subscribed the share capital of 5 million thalers. A few days later, on March 24th and 25th, 1870, the initial buyers offered shares totaling 2 million thalers for the public subscription. The first general meeting of shareholders elected a 24-strong board of directors from among the shareholders. One of its first tasks was to determine the bank's future management. The choice fell on Georg Siemens, a young lawyer who had given proof of his abilities in contract negotiations on the construction of a telegraph line in Persia he had conducted for the company Siemens. Over the next three decades, Georg Siemens was to decisively shape the bank's evolution. At his side was Hermann Wallich, who had previously been manager of the Shanghai branch of Comptoir des Comptes, and who joined Deutsche Bank's management board in the autumn of 1870. Wallich was member of the bank's senior management until 1894, serving over the years with Georg Siemens, Rudolf Koch, and Max Steinthal on the management board.